the solar panels would kind of be spread out between the west, the east, and the south.
What's that going to do to the aesthetics, to the look of your dome? These big panels.
Can I show you something on the computer?
Absolutely.
Okay.
For the past several years, students in Eeva Reeder's geometry class at Mount Lake Terrace High School have faced a severe challenge at the end of the school year.
Open, inviting area.
My students are engaged in a 5-6 week project. It's a culminating project in a regular geometry class. They bring together everything that they've learned in the geometry class and they're applying it to solve a real world problem. And the problem that they have to solve is how do you design a state-of-the-art high school in the year 2050 on a particular site, and this is the site for this year. So you're going to leave the hills as they are?
Yeah.
What are you going to use them for?
Cross country.
Oh, so you're just going to have a bunch of paths through here?
Yeah.
Yes. Nice.
Infer.
Students are in teams of 3 to 4 and they're in a design competition for a contract to build it.
35 by 35 feet long. The back wall is 20 feet tall.
These are
with 2 10-foot pillars.
At the end of the project, each team is required to submit a site plan for their school.
The actual area right here has 5 buildings.
A scale model of at least 1 room.
The front row desk will lower down to the ground.
A floor plan and a cost estimate for construction.
Our total cost was $86,420,122.
Teams submit a written proposal and give a final oral presentation to a team of architects who volunteer their time to judge the relative merits of the proposals.
Football field 100 yards, 300 feet.
Reeder created this rigorous project when she realized that her students weren't able to apply what they were studying in class.
It became immediately apparent to me as a teacher that talking to kids didn't cause them to really deeply learn concepts. And they might learn the material, learn it so that they could spit back formulas and so on a paper and pencil test, but they weren't able to apply it in a context that was outside of that unit and outside of that worksheet or book page.
Why not have the whole site be glass facing the water?
It's when they can use what they learn in class to solve a problem that I know that they've learned the material.
We'd have doors leading to the outside classroom. So
while students must draw on their knowledge of everything from math and English to the aesthetics of design, they also learn an invaluable lesson in teamwork.
We'll see how many we can fit.
I'm thinking because
when we finally started on the site model, there was constant little squabbling about, oh, this should go there.
Just the bottom row itself just holds 1,200 people, right?
No, this entire thing holds 1,200 people.
Oh, the entire school.
They're faced with this really complex problem that has certain constraints, and they have to figure out how to begin to make the decisions and move the process forward, and how do you do that decision-making within a group. These are the things that are really maybe the most powerful learnings that come from it, the real-life problem-solving, communication, collaboration skills.
I did learn how to work with people that didn't think the way I did, and thought non-linear, didn't believe in deadlines sort of thing. They really think out of the box, which is not like me. I'm a completely in the box kind of person. You gotta make sure you work together good.
You might be able to just kind of quickly build a little model of it.
Seattle architects Mark Miller and Kirk Wise have played a key role in the design project for the past 8 years, acting as mentors, coaches, and ultimately judges of the students' work.
There's also escalators.
A hugely important piece of a really effective project is to have the audience for the student work be someone outside of the classroom. So I go out into the community and I find someone who's willing to look at their work.
Which means that you use the sunlight for daylight.
The quality of student work really does go through the ceiling because they care about these architects' opinions.
These are great ideas. You're sort of dissolving the concept of a wall, dissolving this idea of indoor-outdoor.
It felt so good to do it. To present it to like architects really boosted up the confidence, and I really wanted to put an impact on them and show them all I got.
Hi, we're Max. We'll take you to the Max MM.
In the beginning, we decided to start with the floor plans and the designs. Our school has 1 main building with 4 buildings on the side of it, which is connecting with walkways. Can you guys imagine what it would be like just walking into a room and all you see is just 3 feet of wall with brick? and then the rest windows even on top of you. That's what we have in our model right here.
The classroom is built down 20 feet, so the back wall is into the hill itself. The rest of the walls are made of glass. The two side walls are clear so you can look out and have no disruption with your views. The silver pad is a light projection, and the little white square is 360 degree hologram. This hologram is your teacher. This hologram teacher can change for your subject. If you want math, you can get Miss Reeder. If you want physics, you can get Einstein. It's all programmed in.
Education in the year 2050 is very different from the way it was at the beginning of the century. Class sizes are smaller, school budgets are much larger, and most importantly, students are taught differently. Education has become project-based.
Spending 6 weeks on a single project at the end of the school year is a bold teaching strategy, but for Reeder and her students, the gamble pays off.
My colleagues ask me, how do I possibly find time for project-based learning when there are so many concepts to cover, so much curriculum to cover, and the pressure to get students ready for high-stakes tests? And my answer to them is that applied learning or project-based learning is the most effective way to deliver information, and it's the most effective way for students to understand concepts. Once they have learned a skill by having to use it, it's theirs. They don't need to cram for it on the test. It's a way of learning information that works.
If everybody wants to direct their attention that way,
yes.
Whoa,
you
great.
Will see the Rainier Tower.
On the final day of the class architecture project, Eeva Reeder's students went on a field trip to check out some of Seattle's landmark structures.
But the center of gravity for that building is a giant concrete base below the building.
But the most eagerly anticipated stop on the trip was a visit to the architectural firm of Wise Miller.
Good morning. Glad you could make it.
These are sketches that we did for the high school.
The students were eager to learn about the work of these two prominent Seattle architects, but they were also anxious to find out what grades they were going to get from them on this, the final day of assessment.
And then they had the library rotating, and they made a point of saying that it needed to be larger.
The architect's judgment counts for 40% of a student's final grade for the project. It's just part of the sophisticated rubric that Reeder has refined over the years.
I have to come up with ways to assess those products and performances. So I look at the site plan, I look at the perspective drawing, I read the proposal, and I have a scoring guide developed for each one of those. But I think that the most powerful assessment for this project is that provided by the architects.
And again, you will remember this activity your whole lives, and it will make a difference. What you've done is very good, and we want to recognize the best of the best.
With the moment of truth at hand, students were able to taste the thrill of winning or the agony of losing a contract.
We have three groups that we want to recognize: ADP, SK, and Max. If you'd come up.
This was also a time to celebrate the diverse inspirations and surprising talents that emerged during the course of the project.
You had a level of comfort as you presented your work. And when you know your work and you know what you're saying and you believe it, it comes through. And so we wanted your building because you were doing a good job in your presentation. We're ready for best architecture. Best architecture category goes to Yin Yang. Your architectural solution was just very, it's almost animate.
Hearing the architect say something like, now this is a building I'd like to work together with you on. You can't duplicate that experience in a classroom.
But we really like those arms that reach down the hillside, and we could see the classroom learning going indoor and outdoor.
It's so powerful for the students because they have someone who can deeply appreciate what it is they've struggled with and gone through, and someone who can just really let them know what a fabulous job they've done.
Are we ready for the final? Best overall project for this year. I have to tell you that the winner was won by 1 point. The winner this year goes to SK. Come on up.
To hear someone honoring their ideas, that gives me chills.
Their presentation was very strong. Their educational concept was just wonderful.
All of the little details of the hassle of arranging field trips and making all this come together, it's just completely worth it.
For more information on what works in public education, go to edutopia.org.